Hello, everyone. My name is Christopher. I'm a senior consultant with EPMA. Today, we're going to be talking about using text styles to make your schedule stand out or more visually appealing. Now that you have your schedule filled out, linked, and approved, let's make some changes. So let's start with the summary tasks. Right now, we can see that they're bolded, but let's make those a little bit more appealing. What we're going to do is we're going to go into the Format ribbon, and we're going to use the Text Styles button in the Format section. When you click that, it opens up a Text Styles dialog box. In that first section, it says Items to Change, there's a drop-down menu. Click that, and let's select Summary Tasks. As you can see, it's a Calibri font, bold, and 11. So let's make that a 12. Let's make it a little bit bigger so it stands out a little bit more. Let's also add a color to it. Let's make it blue. So when we hit OK, all the summary tasks are now blue. Okay, now let's work with milestones. Each milestone, of course, has a zero duration date, or it is marked as a milestone inside the task itself. Let's go back to the text styles. In the dialog box, let's open the items to change and select milestone tasks. This time, let's make it a little bit different. So let's add a red, let's put a background color to it, and let's make a pattern so we can actually see it and it stands out. Let's drop the size of the font. Click OK, and as you can see, all the milestone tasks are now the way we had it configured in the dialog box. But what about if you have a task that is a client sign-off and we want that to stand out? So what we're going to do is we're going to make it a marked task. The way to do that is by adding a new column. And we're going to go down to marked task. Now that that column is there, let's find the task that we want to have marked or, let's say, again, signed off. So I'm going to select this to yes. Now, once that marked task is marked yes, let's go back up to the text styles. Let's go down to the marked tasks selection. Now that we have the marked task selected, let's configure it a little bit. Let's go ahead and make it bright orange, or burnt orange, excuse me. Let's make it a burnt orange and put a background color to it. In a pattern. Once we have it all configured, let's select OK. And now you can see that it has configured all the marked tasks. But now that we have added the marked column, let's change the name of that column so we know exactly what it's for. So we're going to go ahead and right-click that column header, click the Field Settings option, and you can see the field name is marked, but the title we're going to put Sign-off required. And that way we're going to know exactly what that marked field is for. So now that the column is marked, let's select the task that we want to have marked as a sign-off. Now that it's marked sign-off, let's go ahead and configure that to stand out a little bit further. So we're going to go back to the text styles, open up the drop-down, go to Mark Tasks, and let's configure it the way we want. Let's make this one green, and another little color of blue in the background, and let's put a pattern to it, and hit OK. And there we go. So now any tasks that we want to have signed off will have that style affiliated with it. So if we go to the next phase, we see another client sign-off. Let's select that as sign-off required, and it will automatically change that text style. So what if you have already used your marked column as your sign-off required, but you have something else that you want to highlight? Well, that's another way to do it is by highlighting. So let's add another column, but this time let's add a flag to it. I'm going to go with flag one. And we're going to rename this as a meeting. That way we can highlight our meetings in our schedule. So let's go to one of our meeting tasks. There's one right here. We'll go over to the meeting task, select it as yes. But this time, it didn't do anything. Of course, because now we have to configure that. So let's go back up to our textiles. Let's look at highlighted tasks this time. And let's change this a bit. So we're going to keep the same font, keep the same font style, keep the same size, but let's make this, but now let's make this purple. And we're going to get rid of that highlight color. And put a small pattern to it again. And we're going to hit OK. But what? It didn't, but as you hit OK, it didn't do anything. That's because we haven't selected the highlight of the view. Okay. In the data section, there's a highlight dropdown. Let's select that. I already have a custom highlight option called meetings. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. Now, as you see, that meeting task did change. Okay, now what about critical tasks? Let's go ahead and select the highlight of the critical task. If we go back to the textiles, select critical tasks. Make it bright red. Now we see all the critical tasks in the schedule. There are so many options that you can use to play with to make your schedule stand out, and these are just a few of them. If you look at the textiles dialog box again, you can see all of the options that you can change. Now that you have a basic understanding of how to edit, change, and use textiles, have fun with your schedule. If you enjoyed this and want to learn a little bit more, please visit epmainc.com. Thanks.